Metformin. It is a popular medication for high blood sugar in patients with type 2 diabetes. In today's video, I will expose some of the most common misconceptions and misunderstandings around it. We will talk about how effective it is to use metformin, how safe it is to use long-term, as well as many other misconceptions around this medication. So, if you are taking metformin or considering taking it, you do not want to miss any of it. So stay tuned until the end of this video. Hi, I am Dr. Ahmet Ergin. I'm an endocrinologist and founder of SugarMDs.com, which is a new way of managing diabetes. There's a lot being talked about when it comes to metformin. Endocrinologists and primary care doctors still prescribe metformin heavily as a first-line medication for type 2 diabetes. So you may have heard a lot of bad things about metformin. So who's right? Is metformin really the right medication for you? Should you believe to your doctor? Should you believe to your specialist? Should you believe to what you have heard on the TV, on the internet, on the books, in the magazines, your friends? Who is right and who is wrong? Let's talk about metformin. I will debunk all the misconceptions together with you today. So what is metformin? Metformin is a medication that is used as a first-line agent and still recommended by major society guidelines as a first-line agent. So what it does, it basically reduces the glucose production from your liver. It also increases the glucose absorption in your body. As a result, you do not need as much insulin, which indirectly reduces your glucose. Metformin is not only used for diabetes, but it also has been used for pre-diabetes, gestational diabetes, polycystic ovarian syndrome, which are precursors of diabetes, which all leads to diabetes. So metformin also has been used to prevent diabetes in that regard as well. So it all sounds good, right? So what is wrong with it? So what is the catch? Let's talk about that. So I hear all the time from my patients, the metformin can cause damage to your kidneys or liver. Let's look at the studies. In one systematic review of 17 studies comparing treatments with or without metformin, metformin use was associated with lower death rate. Yes, lower death rate among patients with heart failure, renal failure, or chronic liver disease. Based on that, the Food and Drug Administration, the FDA, updated their advice for metformin being able to be used until stage 4 kidney disease. In terms of the liver disease, unless there is an active or progressive liver disease, metformin can still be used. The reason to avoid metformin in severe kidney failure or liver failure is the fact that metformin may not be metabolized or excreted from the body properly, causing accumulation, which can lead to changes in the body's pH, which is acid-base balance. So number two, they say metformin can cause dementia. Well, that's not true either. In multiple studies, conclusion was that the metformin should be actually used as a first-line agent for patients at risk for dementia or Alzheimer's disease, and there's no scientific evidence either to support the belief that the metformin can lead to dementia. So number three, the third myth is the metformin is harmful during pregnancy. Well, that is completely incorrect. Multiple studies published in reputable journals indicate that metformin crosses the placenta. Yes, that is true. However, that doesn't mean that the child will be at risk. On the contrary, if you have a poorly controlled diabetes, that can cause very significant harm to the baby. Number four, you cannot use metformin if you have heart disease. That's another common myth. That is actually partially incorrect, and I'll explain to you why. Multiple studies to date during the last 20 to 30 years indicate that the metformin is helpful to reduce heart attacks, especially if started early in the course of the diabetes. Clinical outcomes also improve when used in stable congestive heart failure patients. The only time metformin should be avoided is if you have acute heart failure or when you're in the hospital for a chronic disease or acute on top of chronic, such as congestive heart failure exacerbation. Number five, metformin can cause elevated cholesterol levels. Well, that cannot be more untrue. Studies indicate that after starting metformin, the bad cholesterol, which is your LDL, goes down. Triglyceride, which is not innocent either, also goes down. The HDL, which is the good cholesterol that saves you from the heart attack, goes up after starting metformin. It has also been shown that the metformin can actually assist in cholesterol medications to further reduce the risk of heart attacks and strokes. The number six, metformin can increase the risk of cancer. The opposite is completely true. Multiple scientific studies indicate that the use of metformin compared with the non-use was associated with a reduced risk by up to 40%. This means that if you have diabetes and take metformin, your chances of having cancer can be reduced by 40%. What else? Number seven, metformin can cause damage to the pancreas. Well, that's not true. Metformin does not cause any pancreatic damage. On the other hand, can reduce the risk of pancreatic cancer. And I do not even wish that to my enemy. It's a horrible cancer. What are the side effects of metformin? So, we talked about all the good things about metformin. Let's talk about the downsides. As you can imagine, everything comes with a price. Sometimes it could be a drug cost, sometimes it could be the side effects. So metformin side effects can be the price to pay for the multiple benefits you are getting. So side effects can be annoying, they're not necessarily harmful. And the good thing is most side effects goes away within the first couple of weeks. So, what are these side effects? Number one, you may have a metallic taste in your mouth. You may have a mild appetite reduction, which is good. It can cause 2-3% of body weight loss, has been shown with metformin. Nausea can happen. Abdominal discomfort and diarrhea are commonly reported side effects, and that's probably the most annoying. The B12 deficiency can happen with prolonged use of metformin. So occasional B12 testing can be helpful if you have been on metformin for years and years. Now, lactic acidosis, which is a common noise around metformin, is extremely uncommon. Actually, multiple studies show that people on metformin versus not on metformin have a similar chance of lactic acidosis rate. So, what are the other common side effects of metformin? Chest pain, flushing, rash, headache, stuffy nose, cold-like symptoms, or excessive sweating. I hear those side effects in my practice occasionally, but again, these are very, very rare. So, how to reduce the risk of side effects of metformin? That will be the topic of the next video. So stay tuned and please subscribe to our channel so you can continue to have very useful, correct information from sugarmds.com. And if you have any questions, if you have any comments, if you want to share your experience, please do so. You can either call us at 1-800-644-3963. Or you can email us at ask@sugarmds.com, or you can leave a comment down below. Please give a thumbs up and subscribe, and we will see you in the next video.